What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Thrifty, back with Thrifty PS Gamer Reviews. Today we are covering Astro Bot, the cute little amazing game that took families and the living room of PlayStation owners by storm. I absolutely have been excited to bring this review to y'all. I cannot wait to dive in. Hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you for those who show up. Share this video out for me. I truly appreciate it. And let's dive in. So, I wanted to cover all the bases with this one. So, the way we're going to do this is over graphics and performance, gameplay, sound, story, and combat. And if you followed my channel for a while, listened to my reviews for a while, you'll know that this is actually how I have done it regularly in the past. And so, let's dive in. I have platinumed the game. If you follow me as a friend, you'll see that I have 120 hours into the game. Most of those, or it's not most, I'd say about 60% of those, maybe 70, are from my kids, mainly my five-year-old. He plays this game anytime dad's not using the PlayStation. So, yeah, we at this household love Astro Bot. So if you didn't want to hear the review, anything like that, and you just want to know what my thoughts on Astro Bot are, it's a freaking amazing game and you should get it. But if you want to hear the review and hear my thoughts, here we go. So let's start with graphics and performance. I give those a complete, utter 10 out of 10. The color palette is amazing. The way everything pops off the screen and the way that everything just kind of works together is absolutely wonderful. Just the every level is an explosion of color. And every single thing has been given so much detail and attention to, with little Easter eggs, and I love what they've done with it. And it, all they've done is take the original, and or not the original, but Astro's Playroom, and just improved on it. Like, I went back and played Astro's Playroom, and the graphics in Astro's are great and amazing, but these just look better. And as far as performance goes, I've had no issues, never noticed any glitching, no frame pacing issues, anything at all. One of the other things I loved about the graphics was the use of lighting in the underwater areas. I thought it was done really, really well. I really do. I thought that when you were underwater, everything kind of felt good, but mainly the lighting was just spot on and perfect. Alright guys, and with that, let's go ahead and get into gameplay. Gameplay is also a 10 out of 10. And the reasons I gave it a 10 out of 10 are because the loop is super fun and rewarding. What I mean by that is when you go on these levels, you collect a ton of coins, you collect different bots, and they're sometimes tied to other franchises, other IP, and it's just really fun. And then after you beat a level, once that level is done, as long as you made it to the finish, you can go back through it again, spend 200 coins, and use that to kind of be guided to all the collectibles. When you're near one, this bird that you have will, like, put out a sonar signal, and so it encourages you to replay the level, but not to just continually go back and back and, like, for the completionist, it gives you an avenue to get it done. And I do really like that part of the gameplay. The landing zone has some amazing stuff to do, and you can even spend the coins you earn to buy accessories for your bots, and that's actually one of the trophies to get the platinum, is you have to get all the accessories. And so, one of the other things I like about gameplay is that the levels can be very challenging, but even the hardest ones, which I would say, honestly, the square ones are the hardest that I found. There was one of the X ones or cross ones that was a little tough, but it was very, very much it never felt like the game was cheating. You know, it never felt like I was being taken advantage of, or it always felt like it was on me, like I had done something wrong, which was great, because if it's on me, I can fix it. If I feel like it's on the game, I don't feel like I can fix it. So I really loved the gameplay loop in here. And let's get into sound now, because everything clicks, zips, snaps, zaps, and chings just like you want it to. The music is fun on most of the levels, but not very memorable. So, the theme song, however, is extremely, extremely memorable. Like, I will now, like, just... Dun, 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 like, I'll end up just saying or humming the theme song to myself often. And it just gets stuck in your head. But none of the other sounds really do. I do like the way that they have the bots communicating with each other. I think the way they did that was very cute. It was very fun. It was very DreamWorks, Disney, Pixar, which my five-year-old loves DreamWorks and loves Disney, Pixar, and so he loves this game. Because of cute things like that. And the other thing that they did really well in sound was everything that clicks, zips, snaps, zaps, and chings actually does so in a perfectly blended way into the environment and into the soundscape. In other words, this isn't a game where I have to go in and try to adjust the sounds of the effects versus the music versus the overworld versus the menu screens. Like, everything was blended together really, really well. And outside of a lot of the levels being forgettable in their music selection, everything else was really good. So I'm going to go ahead and give sound a 9 out of 10. Let's get into story. So you are Astro Bot, you're trying to save your spaceship, the PS5, and your friends, other bots, from big, bad, evil, green monster who steals your processor and scatters your friends all over the universe. Guys, that is the entirety of the story. Nothing more, nothing less. That's it. And so, yeah, not much to go off of. Now, I will say this. After every galaxy, you get a cutscene between Astro and this big, bad, evil guy, right? This big, bad, green monster. And there's no correlation. But you're on a mission to save bots... You're on a mission to save bots from a big, bad, evil, green monster. And you're trying to build up your PlayStation 5 spaceship during that time. It is a good premise. And it is a good thing to, like, get you out the door, right? A lot of times in these platformers, you don't need a big, massive story. Like, you just don't. You need enough to be effective. To give somebody cool little tidbits here and there, but not enough to where the story is the complete, absolute main focus. Because it's not. In the games like this, it's gameplay, and it is gameplay, and after that, it is gameplay. Like, gameplay is king. And gameplay in this game was fantastic. So the story doesn't need to be a lot. So I'm giving the story a 9 out of 10, but I'm giving it a 9 out of 10 because it accomplished exactly what it was supposed to do. And to me, that in a video game is absolutely what you want to see. You want to see the story accomplish what it's supposed to do. And this one did. And finally, I do want to go ahead and get into combat because combat is extremely simple, but it is also extremely engaging with different item-based mechanics depending on what level you're on. So what I mean by that is some levels will give you these boxing gloves, and you're going to use those boxing gloves throughout the level. So that's an attack, that's a weapon, right, to use in combat. Some of them are going to give you environmental things, but for you, like, there's one where you put a rooster on your back and it can shoot you up in the air. But even that becomes a combat mechanic and a traversal mechanic. So, like, you get it originally and it starts off as a traversal mechanic, but then you have to use it for the boss as a combat mechanic. So, the way they've interwoven combat and gameplay is absolutely fantastic. Like, there's even levels that give you things that don't stick with you the whole time. Like, some of the haunted house levels, those give you a light bulb that you have to, like, use to destroy ghosts. And that is awesome. And those are just a couple instances where the game does that. It's doing that throughout the entire thing with so many different items. They all come in handy, and they all play into ways of spicing up combat, spicing up boss battles, and making the combat feel interesting. I will say this, outside of the boss fights, it is really fun to try to figure out, oh, okay, this one I have to not get hit by, and because it has spikes, and you have to use your lasers that you shoot out when you double jump to kill it, and then there's another one that you have to smash with your fist, and there's another one that you have to try to throw something at. Oh, and here's one that you're going to use time stoppage to jump over cards to then get over to it, to hit it, to kill it. Like, there's so many different ways to work it. And honestly, I think that this game nailed combat to perfection. So I'm going to go ahead and give combat a 10 out of 10. So overall, what does that leave the game? Overall, that leaves the game for me at a 96 out of 100. And it should be a contender for the game of the year. I absolutely love this game. I got the platinum in this game, and because of my kiddos, this will be the most played game in my house this year. I hope that you have had a chance to experience Astro Bot, and let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Thank you all for watching, and stay thrifty. Thank you for watching that video. I hope you all enjoyed it. Please like, subscribe, comment, share this out. You can join the Discord for 24/7 gaming conversations. The link will be in the description below. Also, we do a live show every Wednesday night at 8:45 p.m. Central Standard Time called The Playground, where we get to have a lot of fun, kind of cut loose, and discuss video games and video game news at the same time. I hope to see you there, and as always, stay thrifty.